activity. So this is the video series, and it is a part one of that video series, and I hope you will see all the series to understand the basic concept of special relativity. So to begin with, we must know concept summary, and the concept summary begins with what is relativity, what is Galilean relativity and its transformation, Newtonian relativity, Maxwell equations, and the important one is speed of light. So what is relativity? The principle of relativity is a requirement that the equations describing laws of physics have the same form in all admissible frames of reference. And this is the fundamental definition of principle of relativity. And as we know, the relativity refers in general to the way physical measurements are made in general in a given inertial frame are related to the measurement in another reference frame. So basically, relativity refers to the transformation of one reference frame to the another reference frame, and how laws of physics behave in one reference frame and how it has been transformed in the very other reference frame. It may happen that one reference frame may be in rest and the other reference frame may be moving with a constant speed. So we also know what is inertial observer, and inertial observer is one whose rest frame is inertial, and the quantity is called invariant if it doesn't vary from one reference frame to another reference frame. And we will see what are these quantities in the coming slide. So what is Galilean relativity? The important point is you know that the relativity starts with the very experiment done by Galilean, both thought and practical experiment. He conducted experiment on ordinary moving ships on water and pointed out that the rock dropped from the top of the mast will hit the same spot on deck whether the ship is stationary or moving with along uniform velocity. Now here you will see the animation, and in this animation you can see that a rock is being dropped from the top, and this from the reference frame of the observer who is on the ship, it seems to be a straight line travel, but on the reference frame of the observer who is on the ground, who is in rest, it is the parabolic in nature. So you can see clearly from the animation. So what does it mean? It means that if the ship is drifting along the uniform velocity, all experiments and phenomena inside the ship will be just the same as if the ship were not moving. So there is no preferred inertial reference frame, and we all know that inertial reference frame are those frames which are non-accelerating. So there is no acceleration considered in this concept of special relativity. This is that is a very important point. No acceleration is being considered. Here you can see that if you are moving in a spaceship or in a car or whatever it may be, that you can, and if the spaceship or a car or a ship is moving with a constant velocity, then there is no experiment of physics which you can perform inside that car or a spaceship which will tell that whether the body is in motion or in rest. You will get the same result every time. If the ship is in rest, if the car is in rest, you will drop the ball, it will go along the straight line, and if the car is in motion with constant speed, you will again see the straight line drop of that ball. So it is just a simple experiment which I am explaining here. So there is no experiment of physics, there is no experiment which is based on Newton's laws which tell us that you can differentiate that the experiment is being differentiated on that line, that in rest you will get some other result, and in motion of constant velocity you will get some other result. Now the Galilean relativity is also considered here with two observer. One is observer A's reference frame, and another is observer B reference frame, and observer A is in motion with 10 meter per second, you can see here, and he throws a ball with 2 meter per second, and he sees the velocity of the ball as a 2 meter per second. But here which is the observer B, who see the velocity of a ball as v equals to v1 plus v2, which is 10 plus 2 equals to 12 meter per second. So again you can see that the same thing is being seen by different observer due to their different reference frame. One more Galilean relativity experiment is that I am considering two reference frames. These red lines are being drawn here to consider the reference frame. This is one reference frame of observer A, and this is another reference frame of observer B. Observer A is in motion with constant velocity, and observer B again is in the absorbee is on the ground and which is sitting with the velocity zero velocity, and if some experiment just like throwing off a ball upside is being seen in observer A reference frame, you can see that the ball travels a straight line path, and you can see here that the path traveled by the ball is straight line in nature, and the same physical experiments can be seen by observer on the ground who is on the zero velocity, and the same experiment is shown by parabolic trajectory, and you can see that there is a huge variation in terms of mathematics, in terms of geometry, in terms of trajectory, that one the same experiment in observer A's reference frame is a straight line and the same experiment in observer B's reference frame is a parabolic in nature. So observer B is on ground, again remembering that observer B is on the ground with a zero velocity. So two reference frame are here, one with observer A's reference frame and the other is observer B's reference frame. They both see same experiment differently due to their respective position. And one important thing is that they both agree on the validity of Newton's laws. So they don't, they see that there is a complete validity of Newton's laws in both the reference frame. So there is no variation of Newton's laws, but still they see different trajectories. Now this Galilean transformations, adding some more mathematics to this Galilean transformation, and here is two reference frame considering in as a S and S dash. There is a S reference frame and there is S dash reference frame. Some event occurring P in S dash reference frame, and it is being seen by this in S reference frame. So the common event is being seen by in S dash as well as in S. And earlier, when this S dash was not in motion, this O dash was pointed at O. And you can see at that time the clocks were synchronized, that is at t equals to 0, the both were having same time, and since the motion is in x direction, so there is no variation in y direction, so y and y dash are equal, t and t dash is also equal, so there is only variation in x direction. And you will see that further what we will get here by transforming that. Now, as per this Galilean transformation, we can obtain an important result of Newtonian mechanics which carries over in a much more general form to a special relativity. If we consider motion of a body of mass m in some reference frame, say S, which I've already told you, then from Newton's second law of motion, the force F equals to ma, and a can be written in terms of calculus differential power d2x by d2 square. I have written here, so this d2x by d2 square is the acceleration. Now if we transform this equation into another reference frame, first we have to transform the coordinates, and what we are basically wanted to do here is that if this equation is being transformed in another reference frame, this f will become f dash and ma will become ma dash, and if we get f equals to f dash at last, then we will say that there is no variation in Newton's laws, or you can say Newton's laws are invariant with respect to reference frame. But that means that if the reference frame if the reference frame changes, then Newton's laws, applicability of Newton's laws doesn't change, so they are invariant with respect to the reference frame. Now we will transform these coordinates. First we know that there is a motion in only x direction, so x can be written as final x from this point, O point, can be written as x equal to x dash plus vt dash, where v is the constant velocity, t dash is time. And if we can solve here with x with respect to x dash, the x dash equals to x minus vt dash. Now we will conduct transformation here. Now we know that f dash equals to ma dash, and a dash can be written in terms of d2 x dash upon dt square. X dash we already know that x equals to x minus vt. We will doubly differentiate here, and finally we will get the same equation, m d2 x upon d2 square equals to f. So finally we will get that f equals to f dash. This acceleration d2 x dash upon d2 square equals to d2 x by dt square, we all know that if you differentiate this term two times, you will get as v is constant, you will get d2 x d2x dash upon dt square equals to d2x by dt square. And at last we will get that Newton's laws are in general, laws of physics are invariant and all is well, so there is no problem. So what finally we get? We get that f equals to f dash, and the important point is that there is no variation in Newton's laws with respect to the changes in reference frame, and therefore we can say that Newton's laws are invariant with respect to reference frame and all is well, there is no problem at all. Now, from where this problem comes? So I have written yes, there is no problem, and the problem arises. So where is the problem? And the problem arises with the speed of electromagnetic waves or light, which travels with 300,000 km per second or 3 lakh km per second with the reference to what? And that was the biggest problem predicted by Maxwell equations. So before pursuing further, we must know what are Maxwell equations. Now I must also tell you about James Clerk Maxwell, born in June 1831. He was a notable Scottish scientist and mathematical physicist. His most notable achievement was to formulate the classical theory of electromagnetic radiation, bringing together for the first time electricity, magnetism and light as different manifestations of the same phenomena. Maxwell's equation for electromagnetism have been called the second great unification in physics, after the first one was realized by Isaac Newton himself. His contributions to the science are considered by many to be the same magnitude as those of Isaac Newton and Albert Einstein. In the Millennium Poll survey of 100 most prominent physicists, Maxwell was voted the third great physicist of all time, behind only to Newton and Einstein. On the centenary of Maxwell's birthday, Einstein described Maxwell's work as one of the most profound and most fruitful that physics has experienced since the time of Newton. Einstein, when he visited the University of Cambridge in 1922, was told by his host that he had done great things because he stood on Newton, and Einstein replied the thing in denial, and he said, "No, I stand on the shoulders of Maxwell." But sometimes I believe that he is not given that much weightage as he deserves, but nevertheless he is one of the most great prominent mathematical physicists ever produced, and that's what Maxwell, he was one of the most genius, I can say, and he is regarded by many equivalent to the Albert Einstein and Newton. And these Maxwell equations are beautiful equation which explain the phenomena of electricity and magnetism completely, and these are four set of equations, and you can see for that Newtonian principle of relativity had a successful career till the advent of Maxwell's work, in which he formulated a mathematical theory of electromagnetism, and it basically provided a successful physical theory of electricity and magnetism, and or you can say electromagnetism. It was also anticipated that these equations of Maxwell will obey this Newtonian principle of relativity, in a sense that Maxwell equation should also be the same in all the inertial reference frame. That means that we earlier we have proved that f dash equals to f, so this rule will also apply to the Maxwell equation. But unfortunately it was found that this was not the case, and Maxwell equations were found to assume completely different form in different inertial reference frame. So this was that Maxwell equation era, and this was the you can see that these are four set of equations, and James Clerk Maxwell was a great mathematician and physicist, and he all know that he was one of the great guy on which this whole modern physics is stand upon it, and these are the four set of equations, and when you put the rho equals to zero, that is for vacuum, there is no charge and there is no current density J equals to zero, then you will simplify the equation in this form, and further taking curl of curl, which is a mathematical operation you can do with it, and you will transform this equation in these two forms of equation, and further you will simplify by this putting mu naught and epsilon naught equals to c, which is this equality was the great insight of this Maxwell equation, And basically, what it tells that these equations which are propagating in wave will always propagate with the speed of light, or you can say the speed of constant speed of light c. So we will consider one such equation earlier, and here like this, we will consider one such equation as equation number one in S reference frame. Now what we are going to do here, that we want to transform this equation from S reference frame to S dash reference frame, as we have done earlier in case of Newtonian mechanics, by transferring this force F equals to ma to some new reference frame, and finally we get F dash equals to F. But same thing we are doing for this Maxwell equation, a simplified form of Maxwell equation in S dash reference frame. So now we will transform by Galilean transformation, and now when we transform this equation in S dash reference frame, we will get this extra bunch of terms. And now you can see that equation number one earlier, which we have seen earlier, is not equal to equation number two. Thus we can say that equation number one and equation number two are totally different equation. Now this is the very importance of Maxwell equation, because they don't transform just like a simple Galileo transformation occur in Newtonian mechanics. Now we get two different type of physics here. One which obeys Newtonian transformation or Newtonian relativity, or you can say Galilean transformation, and the other is a physics which obeys Maxwell, which follows this Maxwell equation and do not transform from one reference frame to another reference frame. So here these two equation, equation number one and equation number two, are totally different equation. Now this is big problem in physics, and how can that be possible? Now who is right? Either Newton is right or Maxwell is right. So this is the basic crux of the matter, from where this special relativity drives, and from where this was the idea to get this special rule for this Maxwell equations. And basically you will get in the end that these special relativity is that special rule for Maxwell equation. However, in day-to-day life we don't get at such a speed, so we don't bother about this Maxwell equation, and we will follow this Newtonian principle of relativity. But this is very important for special relativity. And finally we will get three possible solutions. Basically either Galilean transformation was correct or something wrong with Maxwell equation, but this is highly unlikely, because Maxwell equation are beautiful equation for electricity and magnetism, and they explain the phenomena of electricity and magnetism most convincingly and beautifully. So there is no problem with Maxwell equation. Or the second point is that Galilean transformation applied only to Newtonian mechanics, and this is also not possible, because you cannot have two different physics. One is for Newtonian mechanics and another is for Maxwell equation. Physics is universal, it will be applied to all the places at all time everywhere, and so this possibility is also not the proper solution, you can say. Or you can say we have third solution, which is that Galilean transformation or the Newtonian principle of relativity based on this transformation were wrong, and that there existed a new relativity principle valid for both mechanics and electromagnetism that was based on the Galilean transformation. This may be the probable solution. We will see in next episode. You have to continue this series if you want to go through with this. So okay, this we will see in next episode, and either which one is possible solution. For now this is the special relativity part one, and you have to continue with this series. And thanks, please like, share and subscribe. If you have any comment, you can comment on that comment box. Okay, thank you very much.